Hi, I'm Dr. Sandeep Patel. I'm an internal medicine specialist with the Ohio Medical Group. And today I'd like to take a few minutes to discuss the issue of sleep apnea. Normally during sleep, air moves through our throats and lungs in a regular rhythm. In a person with sleep apnea, however, air movement periodically stops or is diminished. Approximately 25% of all adults in this country are at risk for sleep apnea to some degree, hence it makes it a very important problem. There are basically two different types of sleep apnea. Obstructive sleep apnea, which is the most common type, and central sleep apnea. In obstructive sleep apnea, breathing is abnormal because of the narrowing or closure of the throat. In central sleep apnea, breathing is abnormal because of a change in the breathing control and rhythm from the brain center. Our focus is usually on the obstructive sleep apnea because of its higher prevalence in the population. There are many causes and risk factors of sleep apnea, the most common of which include obesity, a small upper airway, which may be due to enlarged tonsils, adenoids, or an enlarged tongue, advancing age, and male gender. There are many symptoms associated with obstructive sleep apnea. Some of these include loud snoring, fatigue, and excessive daytime sleepiness. However, symptoms may also be more subtle. These can manifest with awakening in the middle of the night, gasping or choking for air, morning headaches, waking up frequently to urinate, and just simply, in general, waking up unrested or feeling groggy. So what are the consequences if obstructive sleep apnea is not properly diagnosed and treated? Well, there are quite a few, and they stem from very minor ailments such as excessive daytime sleepiness, difficulty concentrating, and thereby manifesting with increased risk of accidents, whether it be at work, on the road, etc. But these can also manifest with long-term health consequences such as high blood pressure, heart disease, stroke, and earlier onset of Alzheimer's disease. Diagnosis for sleep apnea is rather straightforward. Testing is usually performed in a specialized sleep laboratory. The sleep study itself is called a polysomnogram. The polysomnogram measures various aspects of your breathing, your heart rate, oxygen level, and measures your different stages of sleep to ensure adequate sleep efficiency. There are many treatments available for obstructive sleep apnea. The most common and the most effective treatment is the use of a CPAP device, or a continuous positive airway pressure device. This device fits a mask over your face, which allows the airway to remain open while you are asleep. Various other maneuvers can be employed to help reduce the effects of sleep apnea, some of which may include weight loss, alcohol and sedative avoidance, and adjusting your sleeping position, which may include sleeping on either side as opposed to on your back. Surgical procedures may also be available to you, but only your doctor can answer that question for sure. If you have any questions regarding obstructive sleep apnea or any other health concerns in general, please be sure to ask your Ohio Medical Group primary care physician.